Hello dear students, welcome to the online lecture video series of your second semester SYBSC microbiology course MB221, that is nothing but bacterial genetics. So in the previous video we discussed about the first unit, that is bacterial genetics, in which we discuss the concept, the content of the first unit in details. Now, in this video, we will discuss about our second unit, that is nothing but prokaryotic DNA replication. So, if you know about the central dogma of biology, that generally starts with the first process, that is DNA replication. After that, the second process is transcription, in which DNA is get converted into RNA, specifically the messenger RNA, and after that the last process of the central dogma is translation, in which the information or the message coded by the mRNA is translated into the protein, and that process is called as translation, that is protein synthesis. So to carry out the process of central dogma biology, one should start with the DNA replication. In this unit of prokaryotic DNA replication, we have to discuss about how the process of DNA replication gets started, what are the different types of DNA replication or the models of DNA replication, some of the experiment that carried out to prove the process of semi-conservative mode of replication. Any process, if we have to carry out, we required some prerequisite or the precursor or the raw material, and that to carry out the process of DNA replication, we required some sort of raw material like enzymes, proteins, and the major factor, that is the steps to carry out the process of DNA replication. Also, when we have to start the replication process, we must know about the basic structure of DNA. For this purpose, we have to study the basic of DNA in the first unit, that is structure of DNA, how the DNA get forms, what are the complementary base pair rule, and then we can go for the further studies of DNA replication. So first, in the prokaryotic DNA replication, we will discuss about the models of DNA replication. There are like three of models of DNA replication, like conservative mode of replication, semi-conservative mode of replication, and dispersive mode of replication. After that, we have to study about Meselson and Stahl experiment that generally proves the semi-conservative mode of replication, in which radiolabeled isotope, heavy isotope like nitrogen, N15 and N14 light isotope, we use to study this Meselson and Stahl experiment. After that, we have to study about six basic rules of DNA replication. What are they? We will discuss when we start this second unit of prokaryotic DNA replication. Then, what are the enzymes, proteins, and other factors involved in the DNA replication we have to study in this particular unit? Like some sort of enzymes, you must heard the name, like DNA polymerase, DNA ligase, helicase. So these enzymes and some proteins like single stranded binding proteins, DNA proteins, that also involved in the process of DNA replication. And DNA replication, it carry out in the process, in the three process, like initiation, elongation and termination. So we will discuss all the things in this prokaryotic DNA replication. And the fifth unit or the fifth subtopic of the prokaryotic DNA replication is modes of DNA replication. There are certain modes of DNA replication like rolling circle model mechanism, theta mode of replication, and linear DNA replication. So we have to discuss in this particular unit. So we will study all these things in this particular unit, that is prokaryotic DNA replication. In the next, we will discuss about the gene expression, in which we have to study about the concept of genetic code and its properties, concept of transcription and translation. So when we start the gene expression, we will discuss about that particular concept of genetic code and its properties. Like genetic code, for this purpose we must know about the amino acid, what are the classification of amino acid, what are how many standard amino acids are there and the non-standard amino acids are there. Then we can study the properties of genetic code, like genetic code must be universal, genetic code must be unambiguous. So these are the properties. When we'll start the lecture, we will discuss one by one. And also we have to start the concept of transcription and translation. As I told you, this is the process of central dogma of biology. When you first start with the DNA replication, the next process is DNA transcription, and after that it is translation. So we will study one by one. So we will stop here. In the next lecture, we will discuss about the second unit, that is mutation and reversion. Till then, go through the syllabus of second unit and read. If you have any difficulties, you can ask in the comment section. And till then, thank you.